Hi everybody, I'm back from France, and while I was in France, I went to the supermarket, and whenever they go to the supermarket, the men go off and buy the food. The men all cook all holiday. But I, when we go to the supermarket, I go and wander around, and I look to see what if there's anything worth buying. And I came across a few little items that I spent my pennies on. And the first one was this little gadget. Now, this is more useful for my for me selling things rather than for I might find a use in the sewing things, but this is a little heat press. It's a little heat thing that you, there's two batteries inside there, and there's a little bar that protects this over here, and you can see here there's a little wire, a little exposed wire there. And what you do is, if you've got polythene or anything that you want to heat along, you put that, let me see if I can do this to show you. If you want, if supposing you put something into a packet, so I've got a little cellophane packet like this with a little pocket there. And if I want to put something in there, say some fabric in a bigger bag, say perhaps, and then I want to seal it, I start at one end, and this is a bit fiddly, but I start at one end, I'm going to have to do it this way, and then I pull this across like that, and basically it heat seals the joint there, so that it can't, nothing can get out there. So that was a little gadget that I got, and I thought that was quite handy for me, for my uses for me. If you, it might be quite a handy little thing for maybe bagging fabric that you don't want to open up, or you want to protect it for a long time. I can't remember how much it was. I think it was about £5 or £6, or maybe a little bit more. I didn't spend a lot of money on it, but I thought that was quite a neat little gadget. Another one that I picked up, as I say, these were supermarket finds, was this one, which is, it is a little like a tape dispenser. But what's inside is the tape that you use for iron-on tape for your hems on your skirts and things. It was more the dispenser that I was looking at, and the more the idea, I thought that was a nice idea. So you tape, you run your tape along, iron your strip, and you pull it along a bit more. And I thought that was a good idea as well. It's just basically like a sellotape dispenser. Quick hem dispenser, it's called, and there's 3 meters in the packet. And it's, you use an iron, and it's, you press it for about a minute, it says, a minute with the iron, and it sticks to your the tape sticks to your skirt, the hem of your skirt. A little tape dispenser, a little bit of tape in there, and that, obviously it's pinned in, there's a little pin there, but what I would do is pull it out. It's that kind of very fine hem stuff that you have, and that comes out the dispenser like that, round there like that, put that in there, and then you iron it, you go along and you iron it and pull that out. I thought that was quite nice, little dispenser. Again, must have been about £2 to £3. Then I came across these. Now, these are tea towels, but I thought they were rather nice, and I thought, oh, they were €6.90, which is about £5, I think. And got the ribbon round them, which is handy to use as well, a nice strip of ribbon. You can use that for when you're making those circular bags, or if you're making any pouches for drawstrings. And what I liked about this was, if I pull that off, if I cut that sign off there, they're tea towels, but the cotton, it's a cotton fabric, and I figured that that would be quite nice. I liked the way the fabric was. I thought it would make some nice bags, or something. There's something I could do with it. It's almost like a fat quarter, and there were 2 in navy blue check, 2 in a striped. I like that. I thought that was what caught my eye, the stripe. I thought that was rather nice, that. could even make baby's clothes with these, or baby bibs. And there was also two in, now what do you call this? There's a special name for this kind of fabric. It's actually got like little, it's a bumpy type of fabric. I don't know if you can see that. It's a bumpy type of fabric. And, oh, it's got a name. It's not honeycomb. You'll no doubt tell me. And two of those. Now, not being content with the blue version, I saw the turquoise version and I thought I'd do the same thing. So the turquoise version is exactly the same. It's got, but I like the colour. You could even use this for quilting, really. This is lovely, lovely fabric. Cotton. Ticking, is it like, was it, would you call that ticking? There's that, the stripey, then there's two of these, two of the ones with little, I don't know if you can see, the little honeycomb effect. Again, another one there. And then there's two of the turquoise checkerboard one. So there's a lot there. And that was €6.90. So that's €14. So €14 is about £11, £11.50. So I thought that was good bargain. Then, not to be outdone, I went... I looked further along and I came across some of these fabrics, and they are actually, they look like, I thought they were fat quarters, but they're not. I bought a pink, a nice pinky colour there, and then I bought a blue, a turquoisey blue, which is there, and a royal blue type of effect. It's cotton, and I don't know what it is, 100% cotton, and I got a green one, which that's a green one. So I thought it was a fat quarter, but when I opened it out, it was actually, this is how big it is. So it's almost, and let's see, what is this measure? Let me use one of my tape measures that I got. It measures 75 in length, 75 centimetres in length, and widthways it measures 75. You know, silly me, if I'd looked at the piece of paper that stuck to it, it says 75 by 75. but these are 75 square, and there's quite a bit of, you know, there's a bit of fabric there. So I figured that again, quilting or something else, that would come in handy for me. Now then we decided, what happened, the day that these French people, these people came to visit, because we missed going out to the, the beach. My husband said, why don't we go to the Brocante? And the Brocante is like a flea market. It's kind of, the translation is flea market, but it wasn't a flea market. It's a place that sells lots and lots of antique furniture. Some beautiful, I think I took you last time I went to France. And I went in, last time I was there, they had some very old French patterns. And I think, I'll put a link up there to the actual video where I was showing you what it was like. But these French patterns, they were very, very antique ones. So I started looking for, these antique ones, and I couldn't find them. But I found something even better. I found some pieces of fabric, and they were soot fabrics. And they were still on a piece of cardboard and rolled, like, you know, like flat rolled, a bit like that, on cardboard. And so I picked, there were six of them. Two of them, the colour didn't appeal to me, but I kept thinking, it's like a suit, it's a men's suit fabric. It was really nice. A little bit tatty around some of the edges, but I figured that I could still get something out of it. And so I went and asked the lady how much it was, and she said €5, which is about £4.50 or £4.25. So I thought, whoa, I'm going to get some more of this. So I went and got four pieces. There was four, and I left two because I wasn't, one was chocolate brown, and I'm not into chocolate brown. So I'll show you the fabric that I got there. So I'm going to have to stand up to let you see this, because there is just so much of it. The first one is this. It does smell a bit foisty, so I'm going to have to wash it, but because it is looks like wool, I don't know if you can see, it's like a man's wool. It's I'm gonna have to wash it delicately because I think it is wool. And the amount is here, there's that much, an arm's length for me, doubled, because there are, that is doubled there, and it's also doubled here, so that's actually four, I'm holding four thicknesses here. And this, it's absolutely beautiful fabric. There is, as I say, there is, because it was left lying a bit, that little patch there is all brown, and there is a little hole there. But I think that's just because it's worn a bit, you know, just on that one little piece. But I can still get away with it. The only thing I've got to try is to see whether it will wash properly. It's a heavy suit fabric. It's very heavy, and I was thinking I could make a nice coat with it. I've got an idea for a coat, but I'll have to see if I've got enough fabric. And if I have, then I should watch this space. So that's the first one. That one, €5. Then the next one was a denim colour. I actually thought it was denim, but it's not. It's a denim men's suiting type of fabric. Again, in good not too bad a condition. It has a piece of paper here. It doesn't, I've no idea what that means, because it doesn't really say anything much. It says 603 3507. 3 meters 10 in it. 3 meters 10. Nimmarchand 899 Paul. So I think it's been they've emptied some a suit maker's hat shop, and there's 3 meters 10 here. Again, really, really nice. They make lovely trousers as well. So that's the second one. So I'm well impressed with that. Look at that. Look at that weave on there. See if I can get it. It's got like a herringbone weave. I don't know if it's showing up very well here, but there's like a herringbone weave going one way and then the other way. So that's the other one. €5. Then the third one is a grey, and this is the same thing. It's a bit like the first one, it's grey, and this one is, how many does, 6598, 2 meters 80, but I think, let me just see how much there is. Yes, it might be 2 meters 80 there, or maybe it's more, maybe 2 meters 80 to there, arm's length. And double the width, so that's on the fold, and that's on the fold. So I've got quite a lot. They make a lot of, it's really, really very heavy. Again, little bit of dirt there, just on that fold there. I think that will wash off. So we'll just see what it's like when we wash it and see what happens with it. And then the third one, the last one, that was €5. Then this one, it's like a browny grey. See if I can hold that a bit closer. Browny grey, it's got a tinge of brown going down, like a brown thing, stripy type thing, and then some grey. Another nice one, and this one says there is 2 meters 80 again. Now one of them, I think it's this one. Oh no, there's one of them has a couple of little holes. Well, I think it's that first. Oh, there. This one has again a little hole in it there. Can you see that little hole on the side? That's on the fold. But because I've got that width on the fold, I should be able to get something out of it on without touching the two holes. There's a little hole there, and there's a hole there. The rest of it isn't too bad. I think it's possible that they've been offcuts, because that's where there's a couple of holes just on there and a couple there. But the rest of it, when I looked at it, I couldn't see anything terribly bad. So again, €5. So I got four lots for €5. So somewhere along the line, I am going to be making some coats, some jackets or coats with this lot. I think if I do, I'm not into miserable things like, my camera's dropping a bit. If I do, I'm not into making it too dull. I'll probably add some kind of a pop of colour somewhere. Not quite sure how I'll do it, but I will add a pop of colour. Now, while I was still looking at the fabric, his lordship saw something. And he said, I really want to buy that. I really want to buy that. And I actually thought it was quite nice. So I'll show you what his lordship bought. Right, are you ready to see what his lordship bought? Ready? Should I show you? This is what he bought. He thought it was absolutely lovely. And I have to agree, I'm more of an elephant person, but I thought these two little monkeys were ever so cute. Look at the way, look at the way her face is, because he's giving her a kiss. And he just fell in love with it. He says, I want to have it, I've got to have that. So we asked the lady how much it was, and she said €5 again. So he says, yeah, I'll have that. So we bought that, and that is sitting on our mantelpiece. We thought the kids would love it. When I came back, oh, we had to get all that into our friend's car, because our friends took us down. And when I came back, my friend gave me some fabric, so I'm going to show you that tomorrow or next when I get. I'll do that in the next vlog. I'll show you the fabric she gave me in the next vlog. And I came back to lots and lots of parcels. So tomorrow I will show you what's in some of the parcels. So there you go, ladies and gentlemen, and everybody who's watching, dogs and cats. The cats were thrilled to see me. It took the little black one a long time to tell me how naughty I'd been for being away for so long. And they were absolutely pleased that Mummy came back. And as a thank you present, my little black cat went out for 10 minutes this morning. And within those 10 minutes, she brought back a big fat mouse. Well, it wasn't a mouse, it was a vole. Apparently, voles have short tails. And it was a vole. Somebody else said it could have been something else. And I can't remember what it was. It definitely wasn't a mouse, because mice have longer tails. These ones have little short tails, a tiny little short tails, hardly a tail at all. But they do look like mice. And so, I thought, oh golly, she's already, it was a little present. It was a little present to say, Mummy, I'm pleased you're back. So I'll catch you next time. Until then, bye.